Welcome to Tamer Bowling Video Ball Reviews. Don't forget to subscribe and follow us on YouTube and Patreon. Check out our partner Puret Bowling at puretbowling.com. Welcome everybody, thanks for joining us. Today I want to start a new series known as Tamer's Favorites. You know, we test a lot of different bowling balls and I frequently get asked what are my personal favorites. So today what I wanted to do is share my top Pearl asymmetric balls. For those who've been following us for a while, you know that we've talked a lot about how good and versatile Pearl asymmetric balls have been, to the point where, you know, people say to me, man, you give every Pearl asym a B+. I can only say that we judge every ball by its merits. And many balls can receive the same score, but that doesn't mean they are equal. The reviews are always as objective as possible, telling you what we see technically. But this time, it's subjective. This is my personal opinion on my favorites and why. All right, so let's make a start. First, what I want to do is give a couple of honorable mentions. So, you know, there are a couple of pieces that didn't quite crack my top five. But do deserve to be mentioned. And so quickly, the Hammer Ripped Pearl is the first ball I'm going to mention. It rolls very similar to the Ebonite Choice Pearl. And they could be almost interchangeably for me. And that's a little bit of a sneak peek of what's coming in my top five. But I'll leave that there for a second. The next ball that I want to mention is the Motive Villain Scorn. It's a really good piece, and it's somewhat unique from the rest of the pieces below in that it kind of felt more like a Pearl symmetric for me. I saw it almost like a benchmark type of ball. It is quick off the dry, but definitely wants to see some friction, so it likes to be shaped. But what I will say is it's a bit Marvel Pearlish for me, and that's actually pretty high praise. All right, so let's jump in. Number five is the Ebonite Choice Pearl. You know, this ball looks really pretty rolling down the lane, but more importantly, I like the way it shapes. It's smooth for a pearl, and it's got the big motor. It rolls heavy and forward. So I don't have to open up my angles a ton. And that means I can stay in front of myself a bit more and take advantage of the punch and drive through the pins. And for me, as a lefty, the straighter I can play, the better it is for me in terms of scoring. Okay, so let's move on to number four. Number four is the Storm Intense. This is another heavy rolling piece, and that's almost a theme throughout this particular show for the Pearl asymmetric balls. It's not too fast off the dry. It's not too slow, but it has a definitive move, which I love. And while I found it occasionally to feel laboring for anything lower than medium or high volumes, I found a definitive slot in the bag. And this is the ball I put tons of surface on, actually. Why? Because I know it'll turn over. And rather than use a solid with surface, which is sometimes too slow off the spot, some pearl in a cover still gives it just a touch quicker move off the spot, even at very low grits. And honestly, whether I use it or not, this one stays in the bag for something tricky like the USBC Open Championships. Okay, the number three spot, it goes to the Hammer Black Widow Gold. We're really kind of at the cream of the crop now. And this ball is different than the others in my top five in that it's the quickest off the dry. This one doesn't labor. It's the perfect ball for your typical house shot. I mean, if there was a skid flip of this group, it's definitely the Black Widow Gold. It's really easy through the fronts. And when it sees dry, it really makes a big move. but you also get the hit of the gas mask core. And that's what's kind of unique about it. And this is probably the quintessential house shot killer for me. I just love the shape of the ball, especially for medium volume patterns. And because I can use it on most medium house shots, it puts itself in a good place on this list and in my bag. All right, here we go. You're getting excited. Number two is the Hammer Statement Pearl. So another ball from Hammer in the list. We're right there towards the top. I mean, this is a new one in my personal arsenal, but the shape of this thing quickly moves it toward the top of my list. This ball, as you would expect from all of the Pearl ASIMs, gets down lane fairly easily. It's not quite Black Widow gold length. It's also aggressive off the end of the pattern, but not as quick as the gold off the pattern. But it's heavy rolling, like some of the other ones we saw that we talked about, and probably only the second strongest hitting for me of the top five to the intense. The difference between this and the gold is that this one handles a lot more oil, but it still rolls very well on medium conditions. I can definitely see this becoming my new benchmark Pearl ASIM in my house shot bag and even in my sport shot bag. I really enjoy throwing this ball. All right, do we need a drum roll for number one? Number one, it's the Roto Grip No Rules Pearl. So this is a magical ball. It's not the strongest of the bunch. It's not the snappiest. It's not the cleanest. But the No Rules Pearl is simply the one I trust the most. It just has a shape that I'm in love with. Yes, it's easy to get through the fronts. It makes a rounded but strong transition from skid to hook to roll. It may even look like it's a little slow to flip, but it's not. It truly is versatile. It takes very well the surface adjustments. I can throw it on almost any house shot. I almost always have it in a bag for sport shots. The No Rules Pearl is really on a pedestal for me, so much so that I almost only use it on sport shots now just to keep it as fresh as I can for as long as I can in my bag. All right, so you thought I was done? Well, not quite. Balls are constantly being released, and there are two balls that I thought were worth mentioning from recent releases. Firstly, the Roto Grip Halo Pearl. It's hard to rank a ball without a little bit of time with it, and I have been eyeing it to replace the No Rules Pearl. It's certainly not the same ball, but I quickly shot 300 with it, and it didn't take long at all to figure out what it is. Future installments may have this one crack the top five. Secondly, I want to mention the Black Widow Pink. If you haven't watched the review, you'll know why I'm bringing it up now. Again, this is just released, but I instantly love the ball. And considering how the gold looked long term for me, this ball has a very high chance to make the top five in a future installment. It's a recognizable roll, super easy to throw on a house shot. But the bit of a difference between this and the gold is that it actually is more usable on sport shots. So, it might be too early to say, but I'm almost certain this will be vying for like a top two spot. So, there you have it. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Tamer's Favorites. Stay tuned for future editions. Thanks for watching. If you like what we do, don't forget to subscribe and join us on Patreon.